Helping the Village is a CBO, community-based organization, run by me as the director. My name's being Lillian Okemo. It's based in Western Province, part of Kenya. It's in Kakamega County, in Lubao specifically. And its main aim is to give hope to the vulnerable in the community. Hope in the Village was founded in 2018, and we have several members. We have several members, and the moment the key members we have are Steve Olang, Charles Odwar, we have Mr. Evans Apuka, and we have Mr. Caleb and myself, and other people that are there are not really key people, but they are members of the organization. The main aim was to reach the vulnerable, like to reach them in their home areas, in their villages. So, for example, somebody who is sick, let's say we have a case of a cancer patient, or somebody with another terminal disease. Our main aim was to give hope to the sick, was to give hope to those who are hungry, was to give hope to those who are naked, who don't have clothes, was to give hope to those who are going through other situations that they think this is the end of the world. So to reach them and give them hope, mainly by providing food, providing shelter, providing education, providing counsel, providing medical assistance, and all that. Our main entry in the village, or rather in the community, is children. So it's much easier to reach a family through a child. So our main entry point is children. So we help children, first of all, by clothes, we help them by food, we help them with medical, we help them with education, and we are basing more on education, because if you educate a child, you are giving a future to the entire family, not just to this child. Yeah. We are targeting from the age of 12 to 13. Those are children that have finished class 8 and they are going to form 1, to high school. So those are the main ages we are targeting, or rather we are basing on at the moment for education. Supporting the children for high school education, because every parent in Kenya at the moment should be able to take a child to a primary school. We have public schools that are free for primary education, but secondary education is not free. So secondary education may be a bit harder for a parent, but primary education should be absolutely free, and the parents should be able to afford that. Because it's primary education, so basic. But education, secondary education is quite a bit complex for most parents. So that's why we prefer to start with secondary education, and most of them are from the age of 12 to 13. We have reached over 50 families, and these families, we have been able to reach them by our survey. We do our survey before going for distribution. So when we are going to give food or any material thing, we have done survey, and this is how we've been able to identify which families we are going to. We've had Caleb, one of us, helping us with the survey, and sometimes Charles helping us with the survey, and this has been very helpful. So when visiting these homes, before we go there, we know what is their main need. We may have a home that their main need is not really food, even though they are vulnerable, their main need could be shelter. We may have a home that their main need is not shelter, but education or medical. For example, you go to a home that you have somebody who is crippled. Their main thing that they really need is medical help, buying a wheelchair or trying to get medical assistance for this person, because they have a shelter. So we survey to know specifically from each home what do they really need, and then we reach them accordingly to their need. No, I'm not working alone. Right from beginning, I've had people help me. When I started this, I was alone. The vision was with me, but I could not run it alone. So I had most people. I talked to my friends, And along that, most people have been coming in to help me with whatever way they can. People have helped me financially, some people have helped me with their services, some people have helped me with knowledge, some other people have helped me with advertising us, like Lubao FM, they've been very helpful in advertising us. So we've had so many people come in and help us in different aspects. Different aspects, I mean, not really, you know, when you think of a CBO or an NGO or an organization, when you ask for help, people just think of financial help. We have received more than financial help. We have had donors give us Bibles. We have had people come in just to say, we want to help you with the distribution. We have had people come in giving their material stuff, especially I'm talking about people in Dubai who have given us their material stuff. Have had people come in and give support. And this support I've received from friends in Kenya, I've received from friends in Dubai, from friends in Australia, and the friends in the New Zealand. So like in Dubai, I've received great support from my friends who are sponsoring the children. And this is, I've received great support from Aza Musa, who has helped us a lot, and she's giving us great support. I've received support from Sashi, who is sponsoring a child. I've received support from Malini, who is sponsoring a child. I've received support from Mikael, who is also sponsoring a child. I've received support from Marina, sponsoring a child. I've received support from Yana, who is also sponsoring a child. And I've also received support from the Dubai residents, who give their material things. Some of these people drive from very far to come to my place just to give donations. I've received support as well from my company, who have given us an opportunity to ship the stuff on a discount. I've received support as well from my friends who go around with me and help me to drive around, like Irene, Ahmed Hashem. They have helped me go around and just receive the stuff. I've received support from friends who decide just to go and collect stuff on my behalf. This will be Yachka. She's been very helpful just to help me collect the stuff from people when I'm not available. So everybody has contributed in a way. In Australia, I've received great support from my mentor and my friend, Harvey Bennett, who is working with the solar system company in Australia. I've received support from New Zealand, from Mr. Lee West and Mr. Prestige from Rapid Relief Team. So I've had people come in and help in each and every way that I could not do alone. So I would say, as they say, unity is strength. It's really strength. So mostly we donate food, we donate clothing. We are supposed to do shelter as well. We are supposed to do medical camps, whereby we will come and do a medical camp for just ladies, or family planning, or we will do eye camp, or we will do a general medical campaign. However, like for medical stuff, we have not done it because it involves a lot of paperwork. It involves getting doctors on board to help us. It involves getting the medication that will be needed for that day. It involves getting the tents and all this, getting a proper venue, because these villages are really, really interior, that you cannot just bring a team and say, this is where we are going to pitch the tent. We need to look for either a school or a church or somewhere where we can pitch the tent to have this. So far we have not done any medical camp. However, it's part of our plan. Our achievement, first of all, I say I find fulfillment that the vision is moving. That is my greatest joy. And our first achievement is we have managed to reach more homes. We have reached them with the donations we have received from New Zealand, from Australia, from Dubai, from here in Kenya. We've been able to reach them with our donations. We've been able to help children go to school. So far we have about 7 children who have already joined the high school, and we are supporting them. We have been able to visit their homes physically, and you have seen the kind of homes they come from, and we are more than happy to tell our sponsors that these are really needy children, and in future we look forward to helping them even improve their homes and have a great impact within the community. Yeah, we have a girl called Ethel. Ethel, she's a special child to us. She has a medical condition, but we talked to her, we counseled her, and she managed to go to school with the help of the doctors. And then we have a boy called Andrew. We have a boy in Butler Boys called Ian. Ian was our first child with Ethel to take to school. And we have Abdon Mato as well. And we have Benjamin. So we have these kids, wonderful children. We have personally talked to each and every of them and talked to their parents as well and visited their homes. So we are not just saying that they are coming from vulnerable homes. We have seen the kind of homes they come from. And it's our greatest joy that we are supporting them, and they are going to change the community. Our first challenge is to get certified to run the CBO, because the government, or rather the people involved to give the certification, they really look into us, like, what are you doing, why are you doing this? That was our first challenge. The second challenge was reaching these people, because we have to do a survey. And not all of us who are in the organization, we are working. So getting somebody to do a survey was not easy. Until later, when we had Caleb come in and he's been able to do our survey very easily, to go to check on the children and the kind of homes they come from and the kind of help they need and from these families. Another challenge is these homes are very far, because we are dealing with the village, and it's not just getting to deal with children, we are dealing with the whole family. So when it's the whole family, you have to physically go and visit the family. So sometimes going to these homes, it takes us a long walk, and sometimes a long bike ride, because most of these homes, the vehicles cannot go there. So we have to use either bike or we have to trek. So this has been another challenge. Another challenge is, as we help the children and even help the families with their food and clothing, we get that it will be much stable to help a family with a more stable thing that can give a daily income. Like, we get a family, we have a father and we have a mother who are both jobless. If we give them something to do, a business, it will be a daily income for them, and then it will reduce the kind of situation they are living in. Even though we are educating the child, how about after education, what happens? What of the those who remain at home? So we are trying to look at the means whereby we can also help the parents or the guardians who live with these children. And at the moment, we don't have enough finances to do that. We don't have a donor that we say, okay, we are working under this umbrella, so we have money to be able to take care of all these needs. However, the sponsors that we have that are helping the children is a great achievement to us, and the little money we get and we can put into this, buying food for them, it's okay. But as they say, you teach somebody how to fish, you don't give them fish every day. So even though we are trying as much as possible to supply with them with daily needs that they may need, it's not possible to do this for a long-term period. So it will make a difference for us to get them something that can help. Even a small project for the youth that just came from school, or even for the parents that can work, if you brought up something that they can do, be it a boda-boda business, be it a cereal business for the ladies, but first of all, give them education. Why are we bringing this thing for you? Because I want to imagine somebody has been living in this kind of condition, and you give 50,000 Kenyan shillings, they may not know how to use it. So you have to teach them, first of all, train them. The education is not just for children, even for adults as well. You have to train them. Why are you giving this money, and how can they manage, how to make profit, how to handle losses? So all these things are important. But at the moment, this is the challenge we have. We don't have money yet to be able to run these projects for them. Even a car wash should be a good project for the youth who just came from school. As I said, a serial business would be good for the mothers who are just seated at home, but after educating them how to handle this money. My experience has been that we are dealing with the village. So basically we are dealing with the children, we are dealing with elders, we are dealing with the elderly, we are dealing with educated and uneducated people. So sometimes people look at us with a different motive. Sometimes some homes we go to say we want to offer help, and they think we should help carry the whole burden of the home. You know, some people are actually not even grateful for the help we are giving. They think it's a right. Because we have shown that we have the money or we have the capability of helping them, it's their right to receive the help. So some people really don't know that for us to come to help you, we chose to help you, but it's not that you demand the help. You know, there's a difference between somebody helping you and you demanding for help. And actually, help is not demanded. It's something that somebody offers. So they don't understand this. We have homes whereby you will want to educate a child because we are having sponsors who only do educational sponsors. So a sponsor will want to pay fee, but the parent has to do shopping for the child. But the parent will say, if you want to pay fee for my child, then you have to take over the whole burden, which is not possible at the moment. So you know, the person who is suffering here is not the parent, now it's the child who is going to lose the sponsor because simply the parent said, I cannot take over to do the shopping for the child. So there is this whereby some people do not really see what we see. They do not buy into the vision. Some people don't feel the way we feel. Some people think that they are bitter. Some people grow in bitterness that we are poor or we are in this state because God doesn't love us. Why are you coming to us? Are you coming to mock us? So some people don't really see it to be that we are going to offer help from a good heart. They think maybe you came to look at our situation just to mock us and look at us and use us for whatever reason. So that's why we are very careful, even in taking photos, even in taking videos, we are very careful. We ask for their permission and we tell them that this is not going to harm you in any way. Yeah. So this is challenge number one. Challenge number two, when we walk into a home, expect you are going to meet their financial need. They don't expect that sometimes you're just coming with material stuff. They expect you're coming to meet their financial need, which is not really possible to meet financial need of an entire village. A village is big, so you cannot meet the financial need of entire village. So we are working on bringing up projects so that we can get them work and raise their own money. Challenge number three, getting people to come and stand with us as a big donor who can come and say, we are going to take over the project. We are seeing what you are doing and want to help you. We want to help this community. It's been really hard to get a donor. So far we have sponsors, which we are very grateful, but we don't have the donor. So if there's anybody out there who is looking for people to support, you're more than welcome to contact us. We would be very happy to have you support us. We are working with integrity. You can check us out. You can come and physically walk with us in the village, see the kind of villages we go to. We have all the paperwork in place. So it's in black and white. So we know there are people there who love to help. We know there are people there who love to come and help. But sometimes you have to speak for someone to come. And sometimes they don't know the channel. And with the current world where we have a lot of things going on, we have fraud on internet, we have all these things, it's not easy just for somebody to come up and say, I'm supporting this project. So I'm talking as a director and on behalf of Hope in the Village and on behalf of the people in the village who I need. If there's anybody out there willing to support us in any way, you're more than welcome to contact us. You can contact us through our website, www.hopeinthevillage.org. You can contact us through the website. You can contact us on LinkedIn with my name, Lily Obed. I'm on LinkedIn. You can contact me directly through my email, lily@hopeinthevillage.org. You can contact us through Lubao FM. They are always having our contacts, so anybody on Lubao FM, they'll be able to reach us. and we will be happy to link with you. Thank you all, and just to let you know that our organization is non-denominational. We welcome anybody. Actually, we have on board a friend who has been very supportive of the project right from the beginning. My friend from Dubai, Aza Musa, she's been very, very helpful, very supportive. So everybody, anybody who wants to come on board, you are more than welcome. We are not saying that we don't have boundaries for who should come. You want to help, our goal is to help. Come on, let us reach that goal. So you are more than welcome. I want to appreciate my mentor, Harvey Bennett from Australia. Thank you so much for the great job. Thank you for being available every time that we need you, every time we need your support, your counsel. You've been of a great blessing. We thank the team from New Zealand, from Rapid Relief Team, Mr. Lee West and Mr. Prestige for your support all the time. Thank you for the Bibles that you sent. Thank you for the soap that is on the way for us and more Bibles. We thank you for your great support. And I thank my team in Dubai and my friends in Dubai. I love you so much and thank you for your donations and thank you for a big heart. Thank you for your support. You have been my pillar, you have been my stepping stone to see the brightness of this project, and I thank you all. And finally, I want to thank my presenter, Tom. You can see his number is right there on the screen. Contact him, he's doing such a fantastic job. This is my third interview to do with him, and I would like you to contact him if you need somebody to do a proper job for you. Please be able to contact him. His contacts are right on the screen.